so much for coming back. Our next comedian of the night was born in Calgary, Alberta. She now makes her home here in Toronto, Ontario. Please welcome Allyson Smith.
Hi, my name is Allyson Smith, and I've been doing comedy for 11 years. And what I'm really hoping to get out of this exposure on Byte TV is to get cast into a B-horror film. What made me want to become a stand-up comic? No. The question is, what made me become a stand-up comic? A dysfunctional childhood. The one key moment in my life when I realized I was going to be a comedian was in grade 6, when all the other girls were doing jazz dances and ballet recitals at our talent show, and I realized I sure as hell wasn't going to put on a pair of tights, so I told jokes. I would describe my stand-up style as very eclectic. I do a little bit of everything that is legally allowed to be performed on stage. If I won the 10 grand, I would smartly invest it into my visa.
Oh, well, that's nice. Thank you. All right. Well, that is excellent. So my name is Allyson. Just in case some of you didn't hear, so you don't look up here the whole time like, oh, the Sarah Palin girl. It's true. No, come on, look at it. I look like Palin. It's okay. Laugh it out. Are you kidding me? I'm happy about it. I used to be a lot heavier, and I look like Ricky Lake. So fucking anything's better, people. Working the Palin. Thank you. So this is lovely. Also, as an Allyson, if you're going to heckle me, take it easy on me. I am a crier. Yeah. It's typical of Allysons. See, I don't know if you know this or not, but names say a lot about people, right? Like, whenever you meet a girl named Allyson, she's always the one that's, like, crying in the bathroom at the end of the night. You know that one who's always drunk saying stuff like, I fucking love you. You know, when I first met you, I hated you. But now that I know you, I really love you. Mom. It's true, it's an Allyson. We're crying. Is there an Allyson in the room? I should ask. Just one at the back? Fuck you. Okay. And, see you in the bathroom. Other names, Deans. If you ever meet a guy named Dean, he's a prick. Look, I'm right, yeah. Most of you laughed. Some of you can't because you're sitting with him. Anyway, it's true. Tannis. If you ever meet a girl named Tannis, bitchy. Yeah, it's true. Look, you get quiet because there aren't as many Tannises around. There used to be a lot more of them. They'd always come up to me after my show too, right? They'd be like, hey! My name's fucking Tannis! No. Well, I thought for sure you were a Shelley. My favorite guy's name of all time, my favorite gentleman's name? Jeff. Yeah, they do. I love Jeffs. As long as they're a J-E-F-F, right? You meet one of them fucking Geoffreys, boo. Oh yeah, Buddha Geoffreys. They're always moody and grumpy. It doesn't matter, they're just walking around, they're angry at the world, right? They're always like, everyone's spelling my name wrong. Thank you, I'm allowed to say that because I dated a Geoffrey, so. You can imagine what a good town couple we were, hey? I'm crying over here, he's all shitty and grumpy over there. Hey, thanks for having us over, Tannis. That's great. I came up with my name theory because before I was a comedian too, I'll let y'all know, I used to be a teacher. Thank you. Three people, I was an educator. My best friend always tells me I should never tell the audience I was a teacher. She's like, oh God, don't ever tell the audience you were a teacher. The moment you're like, I was a teacher, they all look at you like, oh, boo, she's lame. I know, I was like, wow, thanks, accountant.
Look at me.
Yeah. But I used to be a teacher. Best day I ever had being a teacher was in a grade one classroom on a Valentine's Day, which is, come on. I know, elementary Valentine's Day, let's be honest, that's when Valentine's Day is at its peak. Right? In elementary school. Because it does not matter who you are getting 30 to 31 Valentines. Right? Delivered to your desk. Right? How many of you made the little pocket that you'd hang on the front of your desk? Remember that? Oh, so sweet. And then everyone would exchange Valentines. And they'd be like sweet, like cute, like themed, right? Like they'd have like a Garfield theme and say something cute like, you know, love you like lasagna or Care Bears, you know, you make me 3, 2, 1 stare. It's early 90s. Thank you for those of you who got that. It's early 90s. Best one I ever got, best one I ever got was an Inspector Gadget one that said, you make my go-go gadget heartbeat. Come on. But I was in this grade one classroom and the kids didn't know I was coming. So I got the best Valentine I've ever had. It was a poem, handwritten, by a grade one girl. It said this, it said, rose are red, veals are blue, chagrin is sweet, but not as sweet as you. Miss Smith, happy VD. I was like, woo, well, at least that explains why I'm so sweaty all the time. You tell your dad I said hi. Okay, okay, that's inappropriate. That's inappropriate. I promise. I'm classier than that. It was her uncle. All right. So I am still a single person. I will admit that. I'm okay with it, though. I'm a happy single person, right? I'm pleased about it. Woo. Yeah. The only time I get annoyed being a single person, single people back me on this, sometimes when you listen to music and you notice every song is about love. Is it every song out there? Oh, love. I'm in love. Get it, need it, want it, hump it, lose it. Love, 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 love. Right now, why aren't there more songs about personal goals and convictions on the radio? Right? That's what I want to hear, hey? Like self-improvement songs, you know? Songs that sing things, you know, like, go to the gym. Get it together. File your taxes. And stop eating chips. Thank you. I'm going to write that song. I'm going to write it. I am. I'm going to call it Take My Advice. I ain't using it. I stay up late. I'm a late night stay-upper. I don't know anyone else. It's like I can't go to bed. There's this angry little 13-year-old girl within me who's like, I'm not fucking going to bed yet. I stay up late. I watch late night infomercials. That's a favorite thing of mine. I want a magic bullet so fucking bad. This is what I gotta say, though. I'm grateful to be a woman in this day and age. Because if you stay up past 2 a.m., all the late night infomercials are penile enhancement products. All of them. I saw one that was a pill, and it guaranteed guys an extra 4 inches. Wow, I know. I was like, whoa, I guess that's a good thing. But then I started to think about it, and I was like, oh my God, no, no, no. If you need to add 4 inches to your penis, you have a vagina. You need to save your money and get a bullet at that point is what you should be doing. All right, you guys are a lovely audience. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Allyson Smith, everybody.
Well, my favorite, and I think the one that went over the best, was Love Songs, how every song is about love, and I wish there were more songs about personal goals and convictions. That's my personal favorite message and joke. Yeah. Support me so I can have a better online presence. I'm excited to be able to do this show with a bunch of comedians that I don't normally get to work with, so I want to get back in there so I can watch the rest of the show.